welcome and guide. A very special welcome to all visitors to our village this day. It is a blessing to have you here with us. Today we celebrate the seventh Sunday of Easter. Our parish, including our school, religious education, and outreach to the needy, are supported by the generosity of our parishioners and visitors. Baskets are available at the doors for your offerings. Please turn on all cellphones. If you desire a gluten-free communion host, please receive Holy Communion from Father John and indicate your preference by raising your hand. Please stand. We are one family of faith. We are all brothers and sisters in Christ. Let us offer words of hope to one another. Please refrain from showing hands. Please join in singing our opening hymn, Sing a New Song.
Give us strength. You nourish us with your very flesh and blood. Keep us one in love, in consecrated. Make us whole in your truth. That the new life you have given us may bring us to the fullness of joy. We ask this through Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Charlie Farrell is going to share the first reading with us.
This cup is the new covenant of my blood. Do this for every day that you remember this.
Keep them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one, just as we are one. Not as though that I protected them in your name that you gave me, and I guarded them, and none of them is lost, except for the son of destruction, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to you. I speak this in the world so that they may share my joy completely. I gave them your word, and the world hated them, because they did not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. And do not ask you to take them out of the world, but that you keep them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. Consecrate them in the truth. Your word is true. As you sent me into the world, so I sent them into the world, and I consecrated myself for them, so that they may be consecrated in truth. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Spirit of it is God's very spirit. She was teaching religion like Miss Marcia does, except she was down in a very rough part of New York City. It was really rough. A lot of homelessness, people kind of on drugs, a lot of broken families. She brought all the first community kids together, and she was telling them, even in the midst of this world, which would be pretty hard to live in, God is there with us. God will always be with us, kind of showing us the way, guiding us along, giving us his forgiveness, giving us his very flesh and blood. Near the end of the day, this cute little girl, this is who is in here, this cute little girl runs up to Mrs. Russell and she says, a piece of paper and a pencil in front of her and said, your name, write your name. Well, she didn't know what to do, so Christine wrote her name on a piece of paper, and then handed back to the girl, and the girl ripped the part of the paper away and had just her name on it. She wanted the thought, popped it in her mouth, and swallowed it. Then she looked, and she said, now I will always have you in my heart. That little cute little girl knew that she was going to go back out into the world that was pretty rough. She needed to hold on to a message. She needed to hold on to that love that she just heard about. And the same is true for us, boys and girls. God doesn't just give us a little piece of paper and tell us to swallow it. God gives us his very flesh and blood. He tells us to nourish us. He comes right within us. So that no matter what hardships, no matter how difficult they can be, God is with us. So boys and girls, we are very fortunate. We live in wonderful families in a beautiful part of the world. God wants us to know that our spirits need to be fed, just like our bodies need to be fed. And so we come every Sunday to you, every Sunday to be with one another, every Sunday to hear God's word and to share in the news. We all have favorite foods, whether it's pizza or whether it's chicken nuggets, but we don't like eating alone. It's always so much better when we come with a family and share, whether it's a hamburger or a cutaway. It's always good to come with family. So that is why we come here, to be with one another, to know that God is right in our midst. Jesus said, where two or three are gathered, I am there in your midst. So let us now pray that we hearts always be open to that nourishment of God, that we will have open spirits to take in the body of Christ. So let me now stand. Let us pray.
Is the faith of the church. We are all proud to profess it.
so that they, in the sweetness of your grace, we may nestle to the heavenly realities here foreshadowed. Therefore, all creation of heaven and earth sing a song of adoration, and we, the angels and saints, cry out, and without end, we acclaim. trials.
For the kingdom, power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you, but not our sins, rather the faith of your church, and graciously grant you peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace with the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Boys and girls, why don't you now go back to your families and give them the greeting of peace. Let us share the words, peace, God's peace.
Thank you. Thank you.
us. Join, Lord, on the other side. Lord, in thanks to you, mercy upon me, Christian Clark, especially to the parents who have prepared these young children for their first Holy Communion this day. Such an important day in life. Know that the Lord is with them all days. And invite us all now to stand. The extension of your hand and blessing is a sign that the love of my heart is being extended to the one I bless. So I invite you all now to extend your hand and blessing over these wonderful young children. May the Lord Jesus gently guide you, boys and girls, as you go through life. May you always know the peace of Jesus, the light of his love, and the joy of his life here on earth. May Almighty